I am bullish gold. I'm also bullish silver. The only problem is I need a signal. I am confused. Okay, I am confused in a sense that I'm seriously am confused between gold and silver movement. I am really confused, but it has good news because 10:15, we're gonna watch no apple pie today, so don't have to worry about apple pie. I'm really confused but happy because US dollar yesterday spiked up a lot, okay, but gold and silver, gold didn't drop much, silver still go up. So today gold go down as US dollar goes down, that pushed the gold and silver higher, okay. But so far silver is the most bullish, but you can't enter silver now because it's so close to that 200. So yeah, entry to long silver was yesterday. Today just no, okay, no. Gold, I do not know why gold seems to be weaker for now. Could it be that it's giving us another an opportunity to enter? If gold has an opportunity to enter, it will be right here this high. If you notice the YouTube, I was talking about this high. No longer, it's now this high. This high will be 1829.1. So it has to break 1829.2 or 1829.3 before can long go. Letting you know that it's something that you might want to think about for 2022. Okay? One of my resolution this year is not to get affected by you guys as much as I can. Gold, silver moving. Guys, y'all always tempt me, ma. Y'all always tempt me. I'm just seeing my position. I ask you, I'm not opening position. I'm just seeing my position. Gold is going up. Front's not moving already. Just break a resistance. It's just breaking this consolidation resistance. So gold is moving up. Now remember, knights. There's two ways you can buy. One is long on weakness, and one is long on strength. Remember these two statements. Pegasus, you will be covered during the lesson. Long on weakness or long on strength. There are pros and cons. Okay, long on weakness, you're able to buy at a low price. But you also have to understand that the bulls hasn't charged yet. So there's a risk. But if you long on strength, it could be overbought really, and the bulls could be tired, then you go in. But the advantage is you know that it is running at that point of time. So think about it, long on weakness or long on strength. So these two have their pros and cons. There's no right, there are no wrong, but you have to understand the pros and cons. So take note of that. Oh, go broke. Go entry price already. Go entry price already. Like half of half lah. Okay, half of half. Half of half, okay. I use the profit to add a little bit. Quarter lah. So I really hate you guys. Really hate you guys. Oh, by the way, just a tip. If I don't say when there's a profit, if there's a profit in gold, try not to close everything. Try to leave 20-30% of your position open and set break even. When you decide to take profit, just take leave 20-30%. Okay, let's see. We are at resistance right now, so take note, the risk is high. We are at resistance right now in gold. Let's see whether can we reach this and see whether we can clear this. If we clear, then let's see. Half and half a truck is 1x1, no? 4x4 become 1x1, no? So, no, what I'm trying to say is, let's see whether gold can finish consolidating and is going uptrend. Let's see whether gold can start running. US indices coming down. Ooh. Why did I half and half? Ugh. Why did I half and half? I should double and double. I should double and double, not half and half. Hit you guys. I'm just trying to teach y'all to follow rules properly. But I'm showing examples on how to break the rules all the time. Cannot long already. If you guys missed it, then missed. Yeah, the good news is at least the BB is pointing up. So let's see. That's why what I'm saying is that don't close everything. If you do decide to take profit, try to leave 20-30% and set break even. I mean, worst case, the 20-30%, you won't feel a thing, because and it will break even, worst case. But if it does move, at least you feel something. So if it does trigger your break even, you won't feel much. I mean, you won't feel the profit of 20-30%. But if it does move a lot higher, sometimes you'll be surprised that your 20-30% can be more than your 70-80% profit. Just let it run. Okay? Just let it run.